Serving you with news, entertainment, and more, we're TV 11.
From ARTS news sources and the public events offices, this is FAN News.
Rear Admiral Dean Sackett Jr., commander of U.S. Naval Forces Japan, was replaced by Rear Admiral Jesse Hernandez during the command ceremony held in Yokosuka today. Rear Admiral Sackett had served as commander of U.S. Naval Forces Japan for the past 2 years. Rear Admiral Hernandez arrives in Japan after serving 2 years in Maffin Field, California, as commander of patrol wings in the Pacific. And personnel changes on a larger scale are taking place at the Pentagon and in Europe. Secretary of Defense Dick Cheney approved two programs affecting Department of Defense.
You're asleep, Talaga Baby, huh? See? You're doing what Jessica's doing now in the bed?
Williams announced a decision by Secretary Cheney to extend the department's civilian hiring freeze through the end of the calendar year. The freeze was imposed last January and, according to Williams, is accomplishing its purpose.
The force folks estimate that during the time this hiring freeze has been in effect, the civilian workforce has been reduced by about 26,000. And you'll recall that the hiring freeze was enacted in part to reduce the civilian workforce in line with recommendations made in the Defense Management Report.
Mr. Williams said that all exceptions to the freeze, including those for Operation Desert Shield, remain in effect. Secretary Cheney also approved the reduction of U.S. military forces in Europe by 40,000 during fiscal year 1991. Officials say the drawdown will begin October 1st and will include 30,000 No units will be deactivated until January 1991. The announcement also said that the reduction of U.S. forces from Europe had nothing to do with Operation Desert Shield. According to Pentagon officials,
sit down, Jessica. Look at me. You're teaching and we will pull down.
Navy journalist Carrie Lager, Washington.
The Pentagon said its announcement of troop reductions in Europe was made after further consultation with NATO allies and in anticipation of an agreement on conventional force reductions in Europe.
Yes, sir.
The consolidation of the military commissary system has created a new defense commissary agency. The DCA assumes provisional control of military commissaries next month and will assume full control within a year. Army Chief of Staff reports on how the new agency is shaping up.
Systems of the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Marine Corps will eventually save $90 million a year. But the man in charge is the defense commissary. End operation overseas, some commissaries were also closed. He hopes to provide patients affected by the closures, which are magnet stores open 7 days a week. The goal for overseas commissaries is to reduce the dollar value of inventory investment, the cost of keeping the store stocked. If I provide such a distribution room and save $25 million for the government
with customer satisfaction. If a customer is not satisfied, we're not doing the job that we're intended to do. General Draska envisions the new commissary system working much like a commercial grocery chain, with one exception, price. He says customers should still enjoy a 25% savings off the cost of shopping in a commercial supermarket. Army Sergeant Jim Fiedler, Washington.
Utah Air Base residents will soon be able to enjoy the cable news network 24 hours a day on their base cable system.
They don't